Hey designers, welcome back to my e-learning accessibility tips and tricks series. Today we're going to talk about headings. If you remember way back to my very first video in the series, The Importance of Accessibility, I talked all about why headings are so important for people that use screen readers, for people that navigate by keyboard, or for people that just want to be able to get to what they need really quickly. So let's talk about how to get it done. All right, if you're not familiar with headings, Heading 1 is the biggest, Heading 6 is the smallest, and when you use headings together, you are creating a hierarchy in your document or in your e-learning that's going to break up your content nicely and make it keyboard accessible, okay? So someone can actually navigate with their keyboard or visually skim through the content really quickly. So again, headings add structure and navigability to your digital documents. H1's biggest. If you're using something like Microsoft Word, it's really easy to add headings. If you're using a learning management system, also really easy to add headings. If you're using specialized software like Storyline or Captivate, it's not easy to add headings. We could talk about that in another video. So if you're in Microsoft Word, skip using all this stuff on the left here to format your headings. Don't just change the font size. Don't just make it bold. Instead, hop over here to the Styles pane and choose your style, okay? You see Heading 1, Heading 2. More headings will appear as you use Headings 1 and 2 because you need to start with Heading 1. If you just start with your biggest heading being Heading 3, it's not going to make sense to someone that's using a screen reader. It's not going to be navigable. So start with Heading 1. Once you use Heading 2, Heading 3, and so on is going to appear here. And you can see all the other options here. This is what makes your document accessible. You have to use the features that are in the Styles pane for your document to be made accessible. So here's an example. I've used headings for this, this is all placeholder text here, but you can see I've broken up this text using headings with different sizes. So you can see that even though you don't know what any of this means, it's highly navigable. I can skim it. If I'm using a screen reader, I can jump to the content that I want to be able to see. Now, if you don't like the way these headings are formatted, that's totally understandable. You can go ahead and just quickly edit one of the headings they don't like, and then go up to Styles pane, right click on the heading you want to change, update to match style, and all the headings that are the same size are going to change accordingly. And I'm running through this pretty quickly here for demonstration purposes, but you can see it's really quick to make formatting changes that then update in your entire document. You can either even make very silly changes like this one for demonstration purposes to show you how quick it is to change everything all at once. Okay, so I have a live page in Canvas, so I can show you how this works in a web editor. So here I've got some unformatted text. It's a page that's going to be all about dogs. So I want to select the text that I want to make into a heading. I just click on this option here. Heading 2, Heading 2, 3, Heading 4 are all visible here. The reason you don't see Heading 1 when you're in something like a learning management system like Canvas is because elsewhere on the page is already using Heading 1. So within your own web editing document here, your text editor, it's only going to start at Heading 2 to make sure you don't duplicate Heading 1. That's an accessibility feature. So types of dogs is what I want my biggest heading to be here. Again, smaller number is bigger. I'll make that Heading 2. These are going to be subsections. I'm going to fill out more information below. I know this is very silly. Bear with me here. And then maybe this is another section I want down here. It can be a heading 2 as well. So again, look for making a hierarchy. If heading 1's blurred out, it's because it's used elsewhere in the page. It's going to be the page title. But I can have multiple sections that can break down into smaller sections. Again, a smaller number means a bigger heading, and you can have subheadings below, and this will make your page very navigable for someone that is using a screen reader. All right, so that is it for this video on headings. Pretty short and sweet. If you like what you see, please like and subscribe. I've got lots more accessibility tips queued up to share with you.